Hello and welcome back, Naples area visitors. My name is Susan. This month we're talking about Naples area butterflies. A caterpillar's transformation into a butterfly has long fascinated humans, the morphing from a crawling land-based insect into an airborne fairy. Florida is home to 10 swallowtail butterfly varieties, more than any other state. Much larger than other Florida butterflies, most swallowtails have distinctive tails on their hind wings. This week we will learn about the giant swallowtail butterfly. The scientific name is Papilio crespontis. This butterfly is indigenous to different parts of North America and is said to be the largest butterfly of our continent. The giant swallowtail is very common throughout the entire state of Florida. It is active throughout the year in the Naples area. This exotic looking giant of a butterfly is very easy to identify. They are the size of a cell phone or larger. Their size gives them the innate ability to glide long distances between their wing flaps. The top side of the butterfly, or the dorsal as it's called, when the wings are open, is a very dark brownish black with butter yellow horizontal lines running across its four wings. The underside of the wings are a buttery yellow. A black band crosses the center of the wing and it is studded with light blue crescents. A rusty red patch sits in the center of the wing. An orange and blue eye spot sits at the inner edge of each hind wing. Last week, I shared that there is evidence that eye spots in butterflies are anti-predator adaptations. All swallowtails have a tail at the bottom of each of their hind wings. It is black with a small yellow oval at the tip. The giant swallowtail is known as a great pollinator, and for that reason are very beneficial to have in the garden. The lifespan of this butterfly is 6 to 14 days. Within that time period, they have a very hectic schedule. Drink flower nectar, pollinate plants, find a mate, and lay their eggs. Eggs are laid on host plants. The caterpillar is mostly black, brown, and white, and could easily resemble bird droppings. A red osmeterium on the head resembles the forked tongue of a snake. When attacked by small predators, the caterpillar extrudes the gland and attempts to wipe it against the attacker. The osmeterium contains a highly noxious mixture of chemicals that smells repulsive. This secretion is toxic to small predators, such as ants and spiders. Studies have shown that birds are not repelled by these secretions, but still rarely eat giant swallowtail larvae. Caterpillars will rest on the upper surfaces of leaves, where bird droppings would be expected. Caterpillars tend to enjoy the leaves of citrus trees, like oranges and lemons. Because of that, citrus farmers consider them a pest and call them orange dogs. Giant swallowtails fly at a height close to human heads and higher as opposed to low to the ground. I read a poem years ago about a person that was trying to assist a butterfly out of its pupa, and the butterfly died. The poem was giving an example of what is known as hardship law. Working through the cocoon develops and fortifies the butterfly's wings. Squishing through the opening squeezes the fluid from the butterfly's body into its wings, slimming down the body and inflating the wings. Butterflies are not the only example of hardship law. It is abundantly evident in nature. Think of the hardships for the sea turtles or the salmon, just to name a few. I hope you are dazzled by this butterfly this season. Check out some of these amazing books about butterflies. Don't forget to visit collierlibrary.org for all your library needs. See you on Facebook.